Can you tell us a little bit about your character and why you think this is such a magic and never-ending franchise?
Well, my character, I play a character called Zola. He's the brother of the White Widow. And essentially, he's a businessman. He's slightly unscrupulous maybe with his business, but he's a businessman. He makes deals and puts two people together who need certain things, so to speak. I don't want to spoil too much, but there you go. Yeah. And the magic of the franchise, well, look, I mean, that comes with it, I'll be honest. As soon as you turn up on set, you see the size of the set pieces, you turn up, you think, okay, so script-wise it says, okay, we're going to blow up a building or whatever. They blow up a building. Like, my first day on set, I walked into the Grand Palais in Paris and you see Tom Cruise and Henry Cavill swinging 100 feet in the air on the Grand Palais by a zip wire, and you just think, okay, we're doing it. This is what's happening, and that's what the magic is about, I guess. To begin with, it is very well established. You want to make sure that you fit in and it all works together. But like I said, between McHugh and Paramount and Tom and everyone, they made me feel so welcome. And
it's a real no-brainer to say yes to.
It's a call you don't need to take twice, I'll be honest, yeah. So. Well, funnily enough, me and Vanessa, we were due to do a film together many years ago, in fact, and it just never transpired for one reason or another. So it's funny that we somehow become brother and sister in this. But we sat down, to just really start to get to meet each other and get to know each other, build that trust. But part of that was building a bit of a backstory, and you know, I mean, and yet when we presented it to Chris McHugh, he was like, look, so much is going to change throughout the shooting process. Don't be rigid in what you're doing, because it really was an exercise in flexibility, I have to say. It's like you turn up, what you were due to shoot that day has just been completely rewrote, or we rewrite it on the day. And I mean, yes, they've got the luxury of time, as some smaller budget movies maybe not have, but it's super fun, basically. Tom is an incredibly focused, incredibly driven man. He pays attention to every fine detail in a shot, whether it's a lapel being out of place on a suit, whether it's a glass being not quite filled up to the right amount for each reset. And when it comes to the action stuff, to see him whizzing down the road at 100 miles an hour, come to us, leave tire marks all up the road, hit exactly the same mark every time, and do that 100 times without anyone getting hurt, without hitting that same bit every time. I mean, there's a hair breadth between something going spectacularly wrong in many of these sequences, and it's only thanks to Wade Eastwood and the stunt team that no accidents, you know, I mean, apart from the obvious, but you know, put that on Tom's head maybe, but it's about that, you know, for something that is such action driven, that it's for the most part an incredibly safe process as well, so.